Hello, Dan here from howtomechatronics.com. In this tutorial, we will learn how we can measure angle and track orientation using the Arduino and the ADXL345 accelerometer sensor. First, I will explain how the sensor works and how to read the data from it, and then using the processing development environment, we will make a 3D visualization of the accelerometer orientation. Before we start with the explanation, I would like to give a shout out to JLCPCB, which are the sponsor of this video. JLCPCB is a manufacturer of high quality PCBs, which are used in many industries for prototyping as well as DIY projects. Once you have your PCB design ready, simply upload the Gerber file, review your PCB in the Gerber viewer, select the properties that you want, and order your PCB at a reasonable price. If it's your first order from JLCPCB, you can get up to 10 PCBs for only $2. To begin with, let's take a look how the ADXL345 sensor works. This is a 3-axis accelerometer, which can measure both static and dynamic forces of acceleration. The Earth gravitational force is a typical example of static force, while dynamic forces can be caused by vibrations, movements, shocks, and so on. The unit of measurement for acceleration is meter per second squared. However, accelerometer sensors usually express the measurements in G, or gravity. 1G is the value of the Earth gravitational force, which is equal to 9.8 meters per second squared. So, if we have an accelerometer positioned flat, with the Z-axis pointing upwards, opposite to the gravitational force, the Z-axis output of the sensor will be 1G. On the other hand, the X and Y outputs will be zero, because the gravitational force is perpendicular to this axis and doesn't affect them at all. If we flip the sensor upside down, then the Z-axis output will be minus 1G. This means that the outputs of the sensor, due to its orientation to gravity, can vary from minus 1G to plus 1G. So, according to this data, and using some trigonometry math, we can calculate the angle at which the sensor is positioned. Okay, now let's see how we can read the accelerometer data using the Arduino. This sensor uses the I2C protocol for the communication with the Arduino, so we need only two wires for connecting it, plus the two wires for powering. Here's the Arduino code. So first, we need to include the wire library, which is used for the I2C communication. If you want to learn more on how the I2C communication works and how to use it with Arduino, you can check my other detailed tutorial for it. Each device that uses the I2C communication has a unique I2C address, and this address can be found in the datasheet of the sensor. So, once we define the address and the variables for the three outputs, in the setup section, first we need to initialize the wire library and then set the accelerometer in measuring mode. In order to do that, if we take a look at the datasheet again, we can see that we need to set the bit D3 of the power control register to high. So, using the begin transmission function, we start the communication. Then, using the write function, we tell which register we want to access. And again, using the write function, we set the D3 bit high by writing the number 8 in decimal, which corresponds to setting the bit D3 high. In the loop section, now we can read the data from the sensor. The data for each axis is stored in 2 bytes or registers. We can see the addresses of these registers from the datasheet of the sensor. In order to read them all, we start with the first register, and using the request from function, we ask to read the 6 registers. Then, using the read function, we read the data from each register, and because the outputs are 2 complements, we combine them appropriately to get the correct values. The output values from the sensor actually depend on the selected sensitivity, which can vary from plus minus 2G to plus minus 16G. The default sensitivity is plus minus 2G, so that's why we need to divide the output by 256 in order to get the output values from minus 1 to plus 1G. The 256 LSB per G means that we have 256 counts per G, or per unit. Depending on the application, we can select the appropriate sensitivity. In this case, for tracking orientation, plus minus 2G sensitivity is fine, but for applications where we need to sense higher acceleration forces, for example from sudden movements, shocks and so on, we can choose some of the other sensitivity ranges using the data format register and its D1 and D0 bits. Nevertheless, once we read the data, we can simply print it on the serial monitor to check whether the values are as expected. In my case, the values I was getting were not exactly as they should be, especially the z-axis, which had a noticeable error of 0.1g. To solve this issue, we need to calibrate the accelerometer using the three offset calibration registers, and here's how we can do that. So, we need to position the sensor flat and print the raw values without dividing them by 256. From here, now we can notice how much the outputs are off. In my case, the Z output was around 283. That's a difference of 27 in positive. Now we need to divide this value by 4 and that will give us the number that we need to write to the Z-axis offset register. If we upload the code now, the axis output will be exactly 256, or 1G as it should be. If needed, we should also calibrate the other axis using the same method. And just a quick note here that this calibration is not permanently written to the registers. We need to write these values to the registers at each power-up of the sensor. Once we are done with the calibration, now we can finally calculate the roll and the pitch, or the rotation around the x-axis and rotation around the y-axis in degrees using these two formulas. For more details how these formulas work, you can check the Freescale Semiconductor application note. I will put a link to it on the website article. Okay, let's make the accelerometer 3D visualization example now. So we are using the same code which sends the roll and the pitch values through the serial port. Now in the processing development environment, we need to receive these values and use them to rotate the 3D object that we will create. So here we need to include the serial library, define the serial port and the baud rate, which needs to match with the baud rate of the uploaded Arduino sketch. Then we need to read the incoming data and put it into the appropriate roll and pitch variables. In the main draw loop, we use these values to rotate the 3D object, and in this case that's a simple box which has a particular color and a text on it. If we run the sketch, the 3D object will appear and it will track the orientation of the accelerometer sensor. We can notice here that the object is actually a bit shaky, and that's because the accelerometer captures not just the gravitational force, but also some small forces generated by the movements of our hand. In order to get smoother results, we can use a simple low-pass filter. Here I implemented such a filter in the Arduino code, which takes 94% of the previous state and adds 6% of the current state or the angle. With this filter, we can notice that the object moves a lot smoother now, but there is also a side effect, and that's the slower responsiveness. We can also notice that we are missing the yaw, or rotation around the z-axis. Using only 3-axis accelerometer data, we are not able to calculate the yaw. In order to do that and improve the overall performance of our rotation tracking sensor, we actually need to include an additional sensor, a gyroscope, and fuse its data with the accelerometer. So we can either use the ADXL345 accelerometer in combination with some gyroscope sensor, or use the MPU6050 IMU, which has both 3-axis accelerometer and 3-axis gyroscope integrated on a single chip. You can find more detailed tutorial on this sensor in my next video. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new. Don't forget to subscribe, and for more tutorials and projects, visit howtomechatronics.com.